Another way to measure the index of refraction is to look at the critical angle. So we have another template. We'll align our disk. But this time, instead of striking the flat face of the disk initially, we'll actually come in on the curved side. I want to check my alignment, make sure that it goes straight through. When I'm on initial normal incidence. And then, as I move this, still making sure that my laser strikes that center point where we've marked the normal incidence, I can see a refracted beam that's transmitted through. But when I reach a certain point, I'm no longer seeing a refracted beam here. Instead, I'm getting just a reflected beam. Now, some of the laser light is coming over the top, and you'll see the continuation of the line out here. That's not what we're worrying about. We're worrying about the part right inside of here where my refracted beam has disappeared, whereas here I still have a refracted beam. And so that point where that beam disappears, it's called total internal reflection. Have every member of the group measure that total internal reflection angle, average your angles, use that to calculate the index of refraction of your disk.